Hello everyone and welcome to another one of our Forex daily videos. So what I'm going to be looking at mainly is the euro dollar here, because we've been talking about today since last week, and as you probably know, we've got Fed interest rate decision tonight, so that will definitely cause some big moves across the pairs, especially the US dollar pairs. And we've also got a press conference after the interest rate decision. Okay, now looking at the euro dollar, we are not looking for any short opportunities at all. We're only looking to get involved in a long trade, and so there's two options for price right now. The first one is that it could continue higher, breaking above this level right here, and that will confirm that euro dollar will basically continue the main trend. Okay, but what I think it could happen is that we could see a further push down, breaking below this low, maybe below this low as well, but basically finding support inside of this zone of the 1.20 level, somewhere around here. So it could find support this previous level, or maybe even down here. And I think this will be a better option for us to get involved in a long position from down here, because then that means we could place a very decent stop loss, and that will give us obviously a nice risk to reward ratio. Okay, I think there is a higher chance that this could happen. Price will fall down before it actually continues higher, rather than just going straight up. Okay, now any of those moves, this is not something that you should be trading. Okay, it will be very risky and your trade wouldn't be confirmed, because during news there's high volatility, and so sometimes price doesn't make any sense. But what will make sense is waiting for that pullback, then price giving you a signal that it finds support somewhere inside of this zone, seeing the reversal happen, and then enter long. Alright, so that's a much better option for you to get involved in this situation right here. Alright, now from tomorrow, basically after the news release and tomorrow morning, there will be a clear market direction, not just on the euro dollar, but pretty much across all instruments in our watch list, because price action here will dictate what's going to happen with the rest of the pairs as well. So from tomorrow, we're going to have much more opportunities. We're going to be more busy, more active trading rather than just waiting. All right. And then if I switch over to gold, I wanted to show you why I said that right now is not the best time to look for trades. And that's exactly why, because as you can see, we've got this sideways market, really price action not going in any clear direction, just moving sideways. And that's exactly why it happens, because in times like this, the bigger players, the ones that basically create the moves, are just not trading. All right, now everyone's waiting out for the news tonight, and so as soon as they get involved with much more capital, then they make the moves, and we have to get in the same direction as they are. So that's why we have to be patient and wait out. Alright, now if you're looking for any day trading opportunities, I would say today is not the best time to look for those, but it's probably better to not look at the charts at all. Alright, you can do that from tomorrow. So be patient, keep your risk at minimum, watch out for price action, how will market react tonight to the news, and we are gonna go through what happened in the next videos as well. Alright guys, make sure to put in the comments down below what you want to see next. Is there any instrument that you want us to analyze? And also join our free Telegram channel, where we post daily free educational content. Make sure to follow us on our social media. You can find the links in the description down below. Send us a message if you've got any questions, and also subscribe to this channel so you don't miss out any of our videos. Alright, I wish you all a successful trading, and I'll see you in the next one.